I was inspired by the Silent Hill remake artwork, and I thought it would be a great idea to create something like this, some spooky horror illustration. Besides, I love fog and such an atmosphere. This is my Blender scene where I built environment, and this is the final artwork in Photoshop where I painted fog, added atmosphere and make color correction in camera raw. So the whole process was equally separated between Blender and Photoshop. I guess I will not talk about each point of 3D modeling, it's pretty simple scene as you may see, and just mention that I found this build in 3D models on ArtStation. I'll put the link in the description if you need them. I just made small adjustments for some models so that they fit the reference and idea. I even didn't use any HDRIs here or other light sources. This is a simple plane with an emission shader that will imitate the overcast sky. And that's it for the lighting in this artwork. But instead of simple lighting, I would rather prefer to have a deep talking about materials. Since this is going to be an abandoned city like Silent Hill, it must be reflected in all materials on the buildings, road and other objects in the scene. For example, we may see some dirt on the wall. Even through the fog we may see some details, and that's why we need to pay attention to these details in a Blender before painting in Photoshop. And it's not enough just using some brick texture in the Blender. Although it may look good in some situation, but not for this artwork. The first one that I want to add to this texture, it's an ambient occlusion and color ramp to control this ambient occlusion. This map adds some dirt to the corners and some areas of intersections of geometry. I would like to invert this effect, and in order to use this ambient occlusion in the material, I need mix color node and use this ambient occlusion as a factor. Of course, we may use some dirt texture, maybe this one, instead of color in the mix node, to add some variety to this dirt effect on the walls. And this already looks much better than a simple brick. I also use this way with ambient occlusion in other materials like windows, glass and other objects in the scene. You may see how simple dirt map and ambient occlusion turns simple texture into interesting and realistic materials. I would say ambient occlusion is a map that never messes up your artwork, so use this one more often to make your artwork much more realistic. Also, we can mix another dirt map into the material to add some streaks on the walls. Change the blending mode to multiply. Also, it's possible to experiment with different blending modes to get different results. I would stay with multiply. Maybe here also change to multiply. Maybe increase these streaks. Yeah, finally for brick material, I want to increase roughness with the color ramp. Since it's going to be some humidity weather condition, all materials must be more specular. And despite we can paint all these details in Photoshop, it's much easier to add them in 3D and get the render with all these details. So I duplicate these materials to other buildings and just used hue saturation node to make a little bit different color tone, so they are not too similar in the scene. Second, let's consider the asphalt material, because this material is really important for this artwork. Since we see a lot of the surface in the frame, this reflection plays a crucial role in the artwork. So basically this is simple texture, mega scans I guess. I use color ramp for roughness to add more glossiness effect to this material, like after rain. But it still looks boring and flat, though it's much better than standard texture. Wet asphalt usually has some a little bit dry and wet spots, it's not like a mirror, you know. For a realistic result, we need to consider such details and try to recreate them. To do this, I add noise texture and color ramp to control this map. And mix with base roughness texture, we got spotted reflections on the surface. This is not much difference, but we can't help but add this effect. Also, ambient occlusion is to add some dirt somewhere here. And I added dirt map just over the whole texture to add a little variety to the base texture. The final wet asphalt material looks like this. I would say that's what I need in Blender to keep working in Photoshop. This is base layer for painting over it. We may see this nice old brick materials with streaks, dust and dirt. Also here is a good reflection as well on the road. But I thought it was a little bit empty scene, so I added car from the Blender kit to cover some empty spaces. Also for details, I added a traffic light here, leaves for the close-up details on the road. Not too many details since it's going to be covered by fog, but now it looks better. And last, what I need in the Blender is a mist render layer. It looks like this, and this is important render layer for working with the depths in Photoshop. I want to paint a fog, and to do this I need this depth information from the render, and this render layer contains all necessary information for me. In the vault settings we can set the necessary range of the scene depths. Maybe I move this volume cube closer to the camera. Yeah, it seems more decent in the foreground now. I also enable CryptoMate layer because I definitely need masks for local corrections in Photoshop. So this is my render, mist pass after rendering. It's a little bit noisy now, so I add the noise here to make it much cleaner. Yeah, it looks good. And let's take a look at CryptoMate. Originally this is a vibrant colored image, but this render layer contains information about all objects and materials in the scene, and I can quickly pick any objects, for example this guy, and make a mask for this object. So I have everything that I need for painting. I save all these renders, but leave the Blender open. I guess we'll return to make some masks using CryptoMate. Of course it's possible to use CryptoMate in Photoshop, but in my opinion it's much easier to do in compositing in Blender. I have a detailed video of why it's much more convenient on my channel. Watch after this one, link in the corner of this video. Alright, I drop all renders into Photoshop. Photoshop it's not free software like Blender, but you can get it for free from Adobe. I use Photoshop without any payment as an Adobe stock author, and if you're doing some renders, illustrations or other contents, you may sell them on Adobe stock, and Adobe has bonus program and sends the redeem key to your Adobe Creative Cloud for active contributors. I have a masterclass on my Patreon where I'm showing how to use Blender to create content for Adobe stock and how to upload that content to get sales. If you want to learn more about how to create illustrations in Blender, sell them on Adobe stock and build passive income, follow the link in the description. And only for those who watch this video, use this code that you may see on the screen to get 20% discount on this masterclass. So firstly, let's add some haze using mist pass. It's different ways to make this. I even use this mist pass just by changing the blending mode to screen, and this already works well, like filling layer, you know. But I'm going to use it in another way. It looks like this. I add a new layer, select this mist pass, hold Ctrl and click on the icon layer. It creates a selection area. Press Ctrl C to copy this information from this layer and add a mask to the created layer. Now go to channels and enable an alpha channel. press Ctrl-V to paste depth information to this mask. If I use the paint bucket tool, we have the same mist pass just using a mask. But I can choose some fog brush that I have in my collection, and if I do paint, it works using this mist pass information as a mask on this layer. It's clearly visible on this guy. I paint fog, but since this character is much darker in the mist pass, all painting works only behind this character. And this will work on the whole art. Where the mist pass has a white color, this fog will be more intensive, and reduce intensity to the black color of the mist pass. Using this way, I can paint fog considering the depth of the scene, excluding some foreground objects and do not make it so flat. I use the same brush for erase tool, just make it softer. Paint with the brush tool and use the erase tool to uncover some parts to show some details from the 3D scene and make it fog softer. It should be pretty dense fog, but not like a white wall. I achieve this using a combination of brush and erase tool. Paint somewhere and wipe with little pressure. Of course, it's better to use a graphic tablet because with the mouse you will not get pressure effect and it will be harder to paint at all. On my workstation, I get used to work with graphic tablet instead of mouse because it's much more comfortable even in Blender. So, if you do not have a tablet, I recommend investing in this device. Even some cheaper Chinese tablet is much better than using a mouse, especially for painting in Photoshop. Next, I want to add a new layer under the fog. Pick some soft brush like that. And using black color, I want to emphasize some dark points in the artwork to make it much contrast under the fog. And again, use the erase tool like in the fog. I wipe it a little bit to make this effect softer, so it will be visible but not too much. I do the same for the foreground to make some vignette effect. Again, not too much, just to emphasize details and add more depth by making the foreground much darker. I prefer to make a final post-productions already at this stage to see what I have. I press Ctrl-Shift-Alt-E to merge all layers into one and make this layer like a smart object. I use Camera Raw in Photoshop for color correction and post-production. Ctrl-A to open Camera Raw. Increase contrast a little bit. Maybe change the temperature to make it cold atmosphere, as this is a horror illustration. Black point pulls down, but increase shadows. Use texture and clarity, I add sharpness to the textures. And the vignette. And of course gain. Gain adds effect like film noise, just not too much. And it also brings more cinematic to the artwork, reducing this digital render effect. Maybe highlight pulls down. In the camera raw, we also can use masks. I want to add one radial mask to this light part and increase exposure. Also, we can use brush to make a mask. For instance, I want to increase this reflection effect on the road locally. Yeah, good. Press OK and now we have a smart layer where Camera Raw works as a filter, which means that I can return to the settings and continue working. Now, when I already understand how it looks, I start working with details. Paint some small details, polish some surfaces, subtract some objects using masks, etc. If it's necessary, return to the Blender, create a mask using CryptoMate and return to Photoshop for painting. To select the whole range of the mask, go to Channels, hold Ctrl and press on any channels. Since it's just a white mask, information will be the same in each color channel. I use a mask on the Group Fog to subtract this traffic light a little bit from the fog. Also, I decided to make some flying leaves, something like this, to emphasize some wind dynamic. To do this, I return to Blender and add plane, scale and rotate it something like this. Also, I need forces like wind and turbulence. Rotate the wind in some of this direction. Select the created plane and add a new particle system. Okay, let's play with these particles. I reduce gravity. I need these particles to fly away, not fall on the ground. Let's increase turbulence force. It must make some variety of the direction of the particles. Yeah, that's it, but it's too much. This is much better. My timeline is 250 frames, so I set this value as a lifetime for particles, so the particles will not disappear during the whole time. Also, I set the frame start value to negative 150. It means when the simulation starts on the first frame, particles already be here, and they start calculating from negative 150 frame. Maybe less particles. Yeah. Also, I select the road and add collision to this object, so the particles will interact with the road and will not fall under the road. See it? Alright, let's replace these particles with leaves. In render, choose collection, and I'm going to use the same collection of leaves as I used for the foreground details. Scale and randomize scale. Enable rotation and make randomize it. So let's choose some frame. Maybe this one would be great. I need only leaves on the render with the alpha channel. So I do a copy of this view layer, name it like leaves, and go to filter, enable indirect only, and select all collections as indirect only except leaves. In this case, the whole scene will be impacted to leaves, but we will see only leaves in the camera. In Photoshop, I guess I place this layer above the fog and add a hue saturation layer and increase lightness to make these leaves closer to the fog. Maybe I add brightness and contrast to this layer. Also, I would add a mask to this leaves layer to remove someone. And add motion blur to this layer, just not too much. So, merge all layers into one layer, make it a smart layer, and use this smart filter with camera raw. As you may see, all settings which I've done in camera raw applied here. I even can open camera raw here and continue making color correction or some other adjustments. So, this is my approach to working on game art, backgrounds and illustrations. The main advice is to think about the step of creating artwork. As you saw, some things are much easier to do in 3D, but another one in 2D. Like in this game illustration, it's possible to make fog in 3D to make a smoke simulation, but it definitely took much more time than I spent painting this fog in Photoshop. And this relates to the whole process. It's not necessary to spend time where it's possible to save your time and even get a better result. Subscribe to my channel and share this video with your friends. Also, if you want to unlock exclusive content, tutorials and support my channel, welcome to my Patreon, all links are in the description. So, I hope this video was useful for you and I hope to see you in the next time.